Michael Smith. Karma has been around the way for a long time. She's wise. She's patient. You can't tease Karma because she'll come back and get you. So, the New York Times, an exhaustive, detailed, well-reported, well-written report on the President of the United States. And we've talked a lot about him and his taxes and his tax situation. And the New York Times went back several years and did an exhaustive study.
2 decades.
Of the president's taxes. And you know what? So the irony here, beyond the big headline, which is he paid $750 in taxes in 2016 and in 2017. That's not even the big one. The irony, a couple of them. One is that our president talks a lot about fake news. And he called this fake news.
Of course he did.
And what's so funny, but what's so funny is that doesn't really apply because the news is based off of what he has reported. It's information that Donald Trump provided to the IRS.
Yes. His own portrayal of his companies.
This is right.
That is,
so
this
if
is
you
not
say
the most, yes. Right.
If you're saying it's fake news, what you're saying is that you lied, which is probably the case. That is one of the that's one of the ironic things here. I'll tell you another delicious irony here is that the president talks often about law and order, but breaks the law potentially.
I told you what that's code for. Law and order is code for, man.
It may be code. It may be code for a lot of things.
That's just one of the pitches of his racist dog whistles. Is law and order, but continue.
If you want to talk about following the law, listen, don't go around, and if you're going to continue to do this, and you're going to continue to support what he's doing, that's fine. Go ahead. Go ahead and support it. But you have lost the right. Don't go around wagging your finger at anybody. Don't talk about the military, because he has disrespected the military. Don't talk about following the law, because he has not followed the law with paying his taxes, among other things. Don't talk about being inclusive. Don't talk about anything. And don't even talk about Christianity. Don't talk about that either, because his entire presidency is like the opposite of the Beatitudes. That's the funny thing.
Also, render unto Caesar what is Caesar's.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
So if you're going to roll with them, go ahead and roll with them. But you have lost the right to take the moral high ground or try to take the moral high ground over anybody else.
Yeah. No, the word
crazy.
Is hypocrisy. The word is hypocrisy for me. And, you know, let's just talk about the law part. It's not just the law. It's about the fact that time and time again, first of all, I told you there's nothing anybody could report that I would put past him. Nothing. What's also frightening is that this will be front page news for about another 48 hours at most until the next bombshell comes out about him. I mean, you lose track of the bombshell reports that have come out about him and things he's said and done. We knew he was a fraud. We knew he was a cheat. We knew he was a liar. He's cheated and lied at every step of his entire life. And, you know, the thing he probably lies about the most, is about loving America and about being a patriot. You love America so much until you're shortchanging the government. You're shortchanging the government what you owe it. Rest of us out here paying taxes probably more than we should, and you're claiming losses and paying $750 in taxes. And that's just a couple of years in his presidency. He went 10 out of 15 years with paying zero federal income tax while paying taxes to other countries, Mr. America First. So it's alarming, but unfortunately, Michael, and let me go to the other point about the Times is preaching to the converted. You're preaching to the converted. There are people who will just applaud him for having good tax attorneys. And there are people who are going to roll with him regardless, because if it were about his character, about his record, about his legitimacy, because he's always been a terrible businessman. The only thing he's ever been good at is being a racist, incompetent, misogynistic xenophobe. That's the only thing he's ever been good at. Okay. And you know what? I will say he's pretty good at running game. Because the only area he's made money on is his fraudulent brand. He's been able to actually make money off of peddling his fraudulent brand as some kind of a adept businessman when he's actually an inept businessman and always has been. Okay, he's been a failure, been the most mediocre. Anyway, but people are gonna still roll with him because if it were about his character and the quality of his character, he would have never been elected in the first place. You know, it's party.
Yeah,
of the
but see, Mike, yeah, you're right. You're right.
No, and you said this a while ago. When you talk about arguments that we've had off camera, I'll say this real quick, Mike.
Oh my goodness.
Arguments we've had off camera. We argue until the wee hours of the morning over text about the importance of Bob Woodward's reporting as it relates to if people would have known before. And you were like, they shouldn't need that. Number one, but number two, they're gonna listen to him regardless. They're gonna swear by him regardless. And this is another example of that. People have already made up their minds, and they're going to side with him because you know what he is doing for the most part is he's doing tilt the high court, the highest court in the land, as far right as he can get it. He's on the verge of getting a third justice in one term, and his job is to turn back the clock and make America great again, a.k.a. make America white again. And he's succeeding in many respects on those fronts.
But Mike,
so it's
I get
not
that.
About whether
okay.
or not he pays his taxes.
Sure.
It's about what he could do for his base, and he's been delivering for the most part, unfortunately, for the rest of us.
But this is what I want right now, because I'm not trying to change anybody's mind. I'm not.
That's
not
impossible
my job.
Anyway.
And I'm not trying. That's not why I'm here. We're just having a conversation. We're just two dudes on Zoom having a conversation, right? So, what I would consider a victory, though, this would be. It would be nice if there was an admission of that, of what you just said, of. If you are supporting everything that he does, if you think Bob Woodward made it up, Bob Woodward exaggerated, he's a liar, the Atlantic lied with the military report, that's not true, the New York Times is out to get him, right. Liberals are out to get him, women are out to get him, people from other right. countries are out to get him. Okay, if you believe all that and that really what you want is your agenda fulfilled.
Yes.
And you see him for what he is, but you just, hey, it doesn't matter. I know what he is, but I want my agenda fulfilled. Just admit that. Just admit it to me, and then we're good. We're good. See, my problem, Mike, is that people don't admit it.
I want us to be good. I hear you, but
they don't admit it.
Yeah, but
I know it's not perfect.
That's great. No, that's great for conversation. I just hope that. If there are people, let's say there are more people out there who, A, haven't cast their vote or might be undecided or maybe they can be turned. Maybe they can be turned. Because he's going to do, it's like, whether it's Russia, whether it's Ukraine, whether it's his taxes, he has never been honest about anything. Like, he doesn't want to be, he wants to be president not because he wants to do the job, he wants the position. He wants the prestige. He wants the platform. He doesn't want the work that comes with being president. And now it's even more clear as to why, because he got hundreds of millions of dollars of debt coming due. So he could use four more years to figure out how to put that bill off. And
Mike, where's the chant? Do I hear that? Where's that chant? Where's that lock her up chant?
Oh, my God. Yeah. I mean, please. Please.
Who's crooked
but so
exactly?
So you know what frightens me, why I'm legit scared right now, because there's this mountain of evidence and mountain of reason for people to follow Cindy McCain and be like, look, I'm a Republican, but I'm country first, and I have to vote Joe Biden in order for the future of this nation. I would love that to be the case. I would love for people to flip. I would love it if this actually resonated with the people that it needs to, because it's not going to be as simple as enough. I mean, look, Hillary Clinton won the popular vote. It's not going to be as simple as enough of us just voting, because I don't know. As much as he's trying to sow distrust and trying to discredit the election process, we know that behind the scenes, he is actively conspiring to try to steal it again, just like he did the first time. We all knew he was in bed with Russia the first time. It was crystal clear why he wasn't successful. Well, we know why he wasn't successfully removed from office. But he has, time and again, there have been reasons to successfully remove him from office already. He has committed high crimes and misdemeanors out the wazoo, for lack of a better phrase. Okay? He stole the election once. He's doing everything possible to steal it again. Either, and now the only difference between now and before is he's doing it out in the open. He's doing it out in the open. So I wish it, I wish I could be satisfied with just admitting that you just want your agenda advanced and you don't care who does it. I'm afraid, Michael, that he's going to find a way to steal it again. I fear for my prayer at night is that I'm wrong. I'm fearful that no matter how obvious this decision should be, he's going to find a way to steal it again.
And I understand. Look, obviously, Mike, there's no satisfaction because you want the best. You want the best for the United States of America.
Yeah. Right? No, I know. I know that's not what you're saying. I know, but, I know you're not saying you'll settle for that. I get it.
Right. But I just think that we're far beyond the point of, and it's fascinating. You know, the political scientist will talk about this years from now, because I'll give him. You want to talk about giving credit? I will give our current president credit for this. He has changed the view of the presidency. He has changed. Like, historically, there's been a turn here. We've never seen anything like this. So the political scientists 10 years from now, 20 years from now, 50 years from now will be writing about it and talking about it, and there'll be documentaries. So I understand that there's a change, and there's some significant things going on right now. I guess I'm beyond thinking that people are going to change their minds. I know better than that.
No, I hear you.
I'm just so annoyed by the finger wagging. That's why I said the karma. You know, this is somebody who will talk about everybody. He's calling everybody names. Yeah, you know, this person needs to be checked for their mental acuity. This person has broken the law. This person is a bad guy. She's a nasty woman. All these things. And you mentioned Cindy McCain. Who talks about John McCain and makes fun of him for being a prisoner of war? What American does that and gets away with it? So I know we're beyond that. But I just say, for anybody who is just going to say, it doesn't matter to me, fine. Yeah. It doesn't matter to me. Yeah. It doesn't matter to you. But don't talk to anybody about leadership. Don't talk to anybody about the right way to be. Don't talk to anybody about loving the country, because you're supporting someone who goes against everything that you say you stand for.
He doesn't. He is the most un-American American president we've ever had.